I thought I'd show you today a very simple technique of matte painting. And the programs we're using today are DaVinci Resolve and Adobe Photoshop. So this is a scene in Leicester Square where I'd like to remove some of these people. I want to leave this guy here walking, but I'd like to get rid of this guy, this very small guy, this woman, there's a guy here by the bike, and then possibly this guy. This was a static shot on a tripod, stabilized in case there's any movement, and really important to do that before you do any effects work. The speediest way I know is to use Photoshop to paint out these people. Now, I don't need to clone the backgrounds. If I actually play the frame and I'm looking at this woman here, from her starting point here to here, you can see that she moves past where she originally was. So I know that I should be able to paint in behind and reveal this detail. And same with this little guy. He's moved from here to here, so this has become free. And the same with the cyclist at the back. So to start off, I've already cut the in and out points of my clip I want to use. And I want to go straight into the color tab for the purpose of doing a little grab. So I'm going to use the very first frame. I'm going to right click and say grab still. It goes into my gallery, and then I want to go through and make sure those other areas I want to paint in are free. So let's have a look. And really, in this example, the end frame is perfect. They've all of them have moved from their original points, and I can use that as my next reference point. So again, do another grab, and this saves them in the gallery. From there, we need to export, so we can open Photoshop. I'm going to leave them as DPX files. I'm going to make a new folder. I'm going to use the clip number, so it's 113 as my reference. So clip 113 for the folder, and then clip 113 for the file. And then that will save two files. And then we want to open up Photoshop and load in those two files. It's just the DPX. Don't worry about the other ones. There's the two frames. So we've got our first frame, second frame, and we're going to bring the second frame, put it inside the first frame, so it's just on one document. We can close the other clip now. So we've got a background, which is our first frame, and layer one, which is our second frame. All we've got to do on layer one is put a mask, and then using a paintbrush, the reasonable size, and then we're going to paint straight over the top, revealing what's behind on the layer behind. So if I close the first layer, you can see all we're doing is putting a hole in that frame, really, to show through what's behind. Let's do the same with this little guy. And then there's a guy on a bicycle over here. Same with him. This guy doesn't move. If I paint over him, you can see he's just moved a tiny bit. So we can leave him in for now. What we need to do now is flatten the plate. And if we bring it in now, it's just going to be a picture. We need to make a hole in it so that live action can show through. So we go back to Resolve and play that clip. What we're looking at is the movement of this fella. He starts at the bin and he walks this light triangle here. And he's just below this sign. And then we want to look for other things moving in the frame. So we've got the trees are moving. This shop awning is moving. This shop awning is moving. So go back to Photoshop. Make another layer mask. And using the same paintbrush, we're going to paint in where we think that guy is going to walk. And we know that we need this awning here, this awning on this shop here. So we're going to keep that. And we know he goes all the way across this sign. And there's a bit of shadow for him there. Don't need quite as much as this, but let's put it in. We know there's nothing in the live action what's going to come in that area, so we're pretty safe. So make sure that's totally painted. And then we're just going to paint over the shop here. We're going to paint the tree. A little bit here. And don't forget the guy who doesn't really move anywhere. Okay, now all we have to do is save it, and I like to save the PSD file so I can come back in and edit it again. So let's save that. And now we're going to export a PNG. So let's export the PNG, same clip name, straight into Resolve. And now we need to go back into the Edit tab. And then what we need to do is locate the clip, the PNG file, in the Finder. There's the folder and there's the PNG. Just drag it straight on top. Let's put snapping on. And just bring that to the same edge. And let's play the clip. Let's reveal that one. So, these people have gone. This guy here as well. So that's the very basic example of matte painting. If we close the underlying, the master clip, we can see the areas where the live action will fill. If you do any color correction work to your underlying clip, as in here, the actual underlying clip was balanced, the white balance, so forth, then you need to make sure you copy those effects to the PNG layer. And then they will match perfectly. This was one example. There's some more examples at the end of this video, before and afters. They all use exactly the same technique. Careful editing to make it less work as possible, and then using layers, masks, and some clone work. Hope you enjoyed it, and see you soon. Thank you.